welcome to the NBA Draft 2017 presented by State Farm. Barclays Center in Brooklyn tonight, just about set to get this draft underway. Here is the commissioner of the NBA, Adam Silver.
With the first pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Philadelphia 76ers select Markelle Fultz from the University of Washington.
The moment for Markelle Fultz, who was on the junior varsity at DeMatha Catholic until his junior season in high school. An avid BMX biker, and now he loves to throw caution to the wind, and now he's going to have to be daring enough to try to lift the 76ers into a winning culture. What are the Sixers getting from Fultz, Jay?
Well, they're getting a guy who's got an NBA frame already. He's got great length, and he's a three-level scorer. He can score from deep, he can score in the middle game, and he can score at the rim. Great body balance. By far in this draft, the best pick-and-roll ball handler in the draft.
It was expected, but now it's a reality. How did it feel to hear your name called and walk across that stage as the number one pick in this year's draft?
It was unbelievable, really. I mean, truly a blessing, something I've been dreaming about. Last night, I was just sitting down, just thinking about hearing my name called, and it was unreal, really. Once I heard my name called, I mean, it was like God calling me. So, I mean, I'm just happy.
You're drafted by the 76ers, which means you join what's been known as the process. But for you personally, you often talked about trusting the process. What did that mean to you?
What it meant to me was anything you do, stick with it no matter what goes on. Even if stuff's not going your way, you still got to stick with it. I think that's what I've been doing my whole life between high school and college. So.
Like so many guys, you're rocking a very nice custom suit, but what makes this suit jacket special is not what's on the outside, what's on the inside. Do you mind giving us a little peek at the lining of the suit there, and tell me about the inspiration behind it and who you tried to pay tribute to with it?
I got my mom, pretty much all my memories inside here, so as you guys can see, I got a little bit of everything in here. I mean, I got pictures, F2G. Just everything that meant the most to me, my great grandma who passed away. So, I mean, this is all the memories that got me to where I am today. So,
how'd you come up with this? What made you decide to do this?
Just a guy, the custom suit. I mean, he told me he can do it. And when I thought about it, I thought, like, why not? I mean, it's something nice. It's something that's going to be memorable forever. I'm going to hang this up and go back and look at it. So,
Kyle, thank you so much and congratulations. Reese.
With the second pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Los Angeles Lakers select Lonzo Ball from UCLA.
You see Lonzo with his dad, his brother, family and friends surrounding him on this moment that family always believed would happen. And as much hype as there's been around the big baller brand, as Jay alluded to, this guy was remarkable in terms of creating for his teammates. He led the nation in assists. He had the third most assists by any freshman in Division I history.
He's basically Jayson Kidd. He's got that kind of size and length.
How does it feel to actually be an LA Laker?
That's a dream come true. Glory to God. And thank you for everybody helping me get here.
Your vision is such a strong part of your game, and you're drafted by a guy that knows a thing or two about that in Magic Johnson. What does it mean to you to have him as a mentor and someone to learn from?
It's crazy. I couldn't ask for anything more, and to be able to learn from him every day is truly a blessing.
Now, I noticed that you are not wearing the shoes that you walked the red carpet with earlier. Pretty convenient. You had to put on not just the hat, but you also had the shoes waiting for you back there as well.
I did. Kind of had that pre-planned, and I'm glad everything worked out.
And I will note, you didn't have them in any other color, right?
No, this was it.
I know your family's with you here tonight, your dad and your brothers, but your mom, Tina, is at home watching. She suffered a stroke in February. What does it mean to you to be able to play at home because of your mother and being able to be close to her?
Yeah, it helps a lot. I'm glad to be home so she can come to most of the games. And she's getting better every day, so that's great. And I know she's happy at home watching right now.
Lonzo, thank you so much. I appreciate the time, Jeff.
With the third pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Boston Celtics select Jayson Tatum from Duke University.
From the, This is the fourth straight year a Blue Devil has been selected in the top three as Jayson Tatum follows suit behind Jabari Parker and Jahlil Okafor. And in Jayson Tatum going to Boston right now, and remember I told you at the top, a lot of teams talking in movement, but if you assume that he winds up and stays in Boston, it seems to me that they are probably getting the most polished scorer at this point right now available in the draft.
Jayson, you told me you haven't slept the last couple nights. How are you feeling now that you have officially been drafted by the Celtics?
This is an incredible feeling. Got to give honor to God to be in this position. The feeling is just everything I wish for and more. I'm trying not to cry right now, but I'm so happy.
With the fourth pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Phoenix Suns select Josh Jackson from the University of Kansas.
Josh Jackson, a high-energy player, finished his one season with the Jayhawks, 13 double-doubles, that's most in a single season in Kansas storied history, was the Big 12 Freshman of the Year. First team all conference, but as Jay has mentioned, the one thing about Josh Jackson is how well will he score? How will the shooting come along? He's a terrific athlete.
Josh, let me ask you, you worked out for the Suns. You chose not to work out for the Celtics because of scheduling conflicts. Do you think that impacted where you were drafted?
Maybe a little bit, but you know, I'm here today. I'm happy. You know, I'm glad to be a Phoenix Sun now.
What do you think you can most contribute to the Suns?
I think I can bring a lot of defensive versatility, offensive versatility. I can guard 1-4 on the defensive end, and I can also play 1-4 on the offensive end.
Josh, thank you so much, and congratulations.
With the fifth pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Sacramento Kings select De'Aaron Fox from the University of Kentucky.
There's old John Calipari, who's now produced a top 10 NBA pick in each of his last 10 seasons. And De'Aaron Fox, after a single season at Kentucky in which he was terrific, goes fifth overall to Sacramento, led the SEC in assists. He is a speed demon, and he has a magnetic personality. During recruiting with Kentucky, players were drawn to wanting to play with De'Aaron Fox. So he is the type of leader and type of personality that you would like to do something for the Kings, who haven't been to the playoffs since 2006.
With the sixth pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Orlando Magic select Jonathan Isaac from Florida State University.
That'll be a pretty short move for Jonathan from Tallahassee down to Orlando. Athletic, skilled guy. You know, he grew 8 inches over the course of his high school career. Now, listen to me closely, especially you, Billis. I'm not saying he's Anthony Davis. I'm not saying that. What I am saying is, being a smaller guy for a long time growing up, learning how to play guard, and then getting tall later in his career, there are some similarities in that aspect in the skill set that he could potentially bring.
With the seventh pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Minnesota Timberwolves select Lauri Markkanen from Jyväskylä, Finland, in the University of Arizona.
And Lauri Markkanen becomes the first Finnish-born player ever to be drafted in the first round. His dad, Pekka, played a season at Kansas and then played overseas. This guy was a guy who was in love with basketball from the earliest age. Drove everybody in the neighborhood in Finland crazy about playing early in the morning, late at night. They finally made the rule, no basketball before 7 a.m. or after 10 p.m. Terrific shooter, big guys you mentioned, Jay.
With the eighth pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the New York Knicks select Frank Ntilikina from Strasbourg, France, in SIG basket.
Frank Ntilikina from France. He turned pro at the age of 15, and a much more positive reaction in the building, perhaps learning from the Kristaps Porzingis reaction a couple of years ago. Is Ntilikina, who is still in the middle of his French League playoffs, in fact will leave in the wee hours this morning to get back for a decisive game 5 in the playoffs.
With the ninth pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Dallas Mavericks select Dennis Smith Jr. from North Carolina State University.
Dennis Smith Jr. was the freshman of the year in the ACC, averaged better than 18 points per game.
With the 10th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Sacramento Kings select Zach Collins from Gonzaga University.
Zach Collins was instrumental in Gonzaga's terrific run all the way to the national championship game, in which they lost to North Carolina, and Collins was sensational. This is a guy who didn't start until his senior year in high school, Jay.
With the 11th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Charlotte Hornets select Malik Monk from the University of Kentucky.
The second Wildcat to go in the lottery tonight, Malik Monk, was the SEC Freshman of the Year and won the Jerry West Shooting Guard of the Year award as well. Averaged nearly 20 points per game. Kentucky history, only Jamal Murray has scored more than that as a freshman. He averaged just a tick more at 20 points per game. This is a guy who likes to spend his time going mudding and hunting and fishing.
With the 12th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Detroit Pistons select Luke Kennard from Duke University.
Luke Kennard, a gifted scorer, played a couple of years at Duke, averaged a little over 19 points per game. This guy is a crafty player. He's ambidextrous. He was a quarterback in high school and threw the ball right-handed. Naturally right-handed, but Dad made him dribble home a few blocks when he was a little kid with the left hand all the time. He turned it.
With the 13th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Denver Nuggets select Donovan Mitchell from the University of Louisville.
So the Nuggets add Donovan Mitchell to that already crowded backcourt. Now, we saw him at the draft combine show off his athleticism. He led all the combine participants with a standing vertical 36.5 inches, three-quarter court sprint in just over 3 seconds.
With the 14th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Miami Heat select Bam Adebayo from the University of Kentucky.
A third Wildcat comes off the board in the lottery portion of the draft. Bam Adebayo, a 7'3 wingspan. His given name is Ed Reese. He became Bam as a young tyke when he was watching the Flintstones.
With the 15th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Portland Trail Blazers select Justin Jackson from the University of North Carolina.
Justin Jackson of the national champion Tar Heels, a first-team All-American last year, averaged a little better than 18 points, 5 rebounds. He was the ACC Player of the Year for Roy Williams and the national champions.
With the 16th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Chicago Bulls select Justin Patton from Creighton University.
So the Bulls make the pick of Patton, but he'll be on his way to Minnesota.
But he's got a very good skill level, and he's got the ability going forward to be an excellent player because he can play on both ends of the floor.
With the 17th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Milwaukee Bucks select DJ Wilson from the University of Michigan. With the 18th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Indiana Pacers select TJ Leaf from UCLA.
Second Bruin to go tonight, TJ Leaf, who played so well with Lonzo Ball in their lone season in Westwood, first team all Pac-12 player. Comes from a basketball family, as so many of these guys do.
With the 19th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Atlanta Hawks select John Collins from Wake Forest University.
John Collins was terrific for Danny Manning in Wake Forest this past season. Got 19 points per game. First ACC player to average 19, 9 boards, and shoot 60% since Tim Duncan another Demon Deacon did it the 96-97 season. If you look at those player efficiency ratings that John Hollinger does, John Collins led the nation in player efficiency rating.
With the 20th pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Portland Trail Blazers select Harry Giles from Duke University. With the 21st pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Oklahoma City Thunder select Terrence Ferguson from Dallas, Texas, and the Adelaide 36ers in Australia. And with the 22nd pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Brooklyn Nets select Jared Allen from the University of Texas.
Jared Allen played a season in Texas, Big 12 all-tournament team. Perhaps if you're an avid watcher of Big 12 basketball, you heard our buddy Fran Fraschilla when he dunked on West Virginia.
And with the 23rd pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Toronto Raptors select OG Anunoby from Indiana University.
OG Anunoby, he missed the last 15 games of his season playing for Tom Crean at Indiana with a right knee injury, surgically repaired, but he improved himself.
With the 24th pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Utah Jazz select Tyler Lydon from Syracuse University. With the 25th pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Orlando Magic select Andrzej Pasechniks from Riga, Latvia, and CB Gran Canaria in Spain. With the 26th pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Portland Trail Blazers select Caleb Swanigan from Purdue University. With the 27th pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Brooklyn Nets select Kyle Kuzma from the University of Utah. With the 28th pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Los Angeles Lakers select Tony Bradley from the University of North Carolina. And with the 29th pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Derek White from the University of Colorado. With the 30th pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the Utah Jazz select Josh Hart from Villanova University.
So Derek White.
That marks the end of the first round. Thank you to the great fans here in Barclays. We really appreciate your being here.